Thank you, thank you, thank you. Hey guys, this is your boy Rusian, and this is the new Rapelzi News. All right, and as you guys know, this is a weekly news, but I have not been doing those news every week, and there are reasons for that. As you notice, a lot of things change, the studio, there are a lot of new things coming up too. But today in the news, we will be covering the Ear of the Red and also Tarja's interview. And on the next few weeks, since I've been able to tone down and work a lot of things on the Chains on the channel, I will be coming up also with the guides I have promised, be for crafting pets and all that nice stuff. Just wait and bear with me, guys, okay? And how about the servers restart? The servers restarted just fine. A lot of work from the guys of Webzen and Rapelzi. And we may have lost a couple of things. But it's alright, because the Ear of the Red event started, and I can tell you guys, the drops are doing great. So you can find, at least that I have checked, drops at Circus, drops at Underground, drops everywhere. So I cannot vouch for the lower dungeons, but I would not see why not. And people can get a lot of good stuff. Now, some issues people are having already is, compared to the last year's Ear of the Pig, Ear of the Red, all the cards are timed for about 21 days. That's bringing up some issues on Discord, and probably they're gonna be coming up in the forums as well because of the small timing of those cards and also of the items that you can acquire from them. So I don't know if that's something that they may be changing soon or something that's gonna stick. But hey, like I said, it's a lot of drops. Hopefully they will not change the amount of drops of the cards, as I believe it happened last year, but it's something we gotta see. I'm not going to list all the items that can drop. I'm just going to tell you, you guys gotta check in the forums, a lot of different things. And I really don't think people should be complaining too much about it. Now, let's skip right after that and jump into Tarja's interview. How long have you been involved with Rapelzi and Webzen, and at what level is your involvement?
I've been playing Rapelzi since 2009. I was chosen to become a QA tester in late 2017, and then I was also made a moderator shortly afterwards. My involvement as a QA can vary greatly. In the past, we have gone through periods where I haven't had much to do. It did take some time between the QA team being formed and us being given our first real task. However, there have also been times where we've been working on changes daily. Nazgul would adjust various skills, then we would be tasked with testing those changes and giving feedback for him to change the next day. Being Korea, the time zone difference was quite useful during this period, because we made a lot of changes in a very short period of time. Lately, there hasn't been much for us to test, but we are still asked for our opinions on various changes. But things are changing. As a moderator, it's more a personal involvement. I try to be the sort of mod that I would like to have. I'm around on the Discord and in-game daily, although I remain hidden in the game. But if people need any help, they can, and regularly do, message me on the Discord. I want to serve as best as I can as a link between players and the GMs, giving as much information as I'm able to and passing on the issues players are having.
No matter how much we may love our jobs, there are always downsides and the not so great or just tiresome parts. What are the top and lowest parts of your position?
Gallus resistance can be annoying at times. There can be particular changes we want to make and they will just come back and say no. But then there are other times when we suggest things that even we think might be a bit out there and they will give us the go ahead. I do struggle with the moderator bit at times. I'm not great with people, something I made clear on my initial QA application. However, I still want to try as best as I can to be the kind of moderator I would like to see. I do make mistakes. As much as I would like it if there was, there's nothing that tells you how to be a good moderator. So it's something I'm having to try to figure out for myself, mostly through trial and error. I am very lucky to have been picked as a QA. I have the ability to influence changes in a game I've probably spent far too long playing, but seeing those changes make it in the game is a great feeling. To begin with, changes were quite small. I think the entire QA team was just finding out what we could do. At the time, it was unheard of for a regular player, not affiliated with WebZen or Gala, to be able to make such changes. As things progressed though, we grew more confident and made bigger changes.
And what are the things that players expect from a moderator, but that cannot be done at your level?
I think some players expect moderators to be able to do a lot more than we can. I get frequent messages regarding tickets that have been submitted, but when it comes to customer service issues, I can't help out. I can't do anything about general player misconduct. Sometimes I get messages about someone PK'd, and I have to tell them I can't do anything about that.
So, what are the things that you can do? For players, that is.
I can point them towards where they can go and report such issues, or give them advice and information they need. It's not a particularly glamorous job, though.
One thing that's been brought to my attention by players, moderator events. What happened to them?
If you mean the boss summoning events, to my knowledge, those were done by either Eva or Hawk. It could be that they just haven't had the time to do them. Personally, I would love to do some events. I just don't know how to. Even if I can't do boss summoning events, I could do other events. There is a player on Raviak that is quite well known for their events, but I could do some prizes, and probably some world buffs too. If players would like to see more events, then all they need to do is tag Nesco and say, "Stop being a bum and teach the newbie mods how to do events."
That's exactly what some have been asking for, fun events, not just boss summoning events. So I hear that you work very close to Nazgul. How is that experience like?
It's amusing. We're both idiots with some really dumb ideas. We both make mistakes, lots of things go wrong, but some of it is just very amusing. When testing the marksman changes, there was an issue with Snare of Corrosion. Someone had set it so that instead of decreasing the stats of targets hit by it, they're increased instead.
So, are you guys working on anything for the near future of Rapelzi?
This is a good question. From my perspective, I would say that while Nazgul was taken away from Rapelzi, Rapelzi remained with him, and he continued to want to develop the game. So, some time ago, he came to me with a really dumb question. Not because the question itself was dumb, but because there was no way I could say no to it. The result is 7. 7 is an ambitious project, something that we hope will excite all Rapelzi players. No matter whether they're just starting out or they're 210, there is something for everyone. And we hope that it will change how people look at Rapelzi content updates, as this should hopefully be a start of something much bigger. A lot of work has gone on it already. There have been stages of development I'm not sure either of us expected we would be doing. But things are coming together now. We've stepped up a gear and we're both hopeful that we can get this done and that we can share it with players soon.
So, since you have been playing and involved in the game since 2009, what changes would you want to see in the game?
There are a lot of things I want to see in the game. Over time, Rappel Z has added more and more RNG-based rubbish. To me, that has made the game less and less accessible. Players have become increasingly more invested in their gear, to the point that class balancing changes worry them in case their gear becomes worthless overnight. I want Rappel Z to become more accessible again, to make it so that all players can achieve what is technically possible, rather than only a very small number of players being able to do so. There are a lot of things in Rappel Z that could be improved or streamlined. There are endless suggestions from players too. Since players are becoming invested in their gears even more, they would like it if the perfect transfer scroll transferred the fact that the equipment has been upgraded to the Raviac set, or to have some way to recover some of the materials required to upgrade the equipment. I don't think those are unreasonable suggestions. Consumables are something else they would like to see change on, given 1 hour version for the various pieces. I suppose I want to see player concerns reflected in the game more.
Now, Torja, the floor is yours. What message would you like to send to the players?
The Ringwraith has returned and will usher in a new era. Only those with the wit to adapt or the strength to resist will be able to thrive as the world is reshaped.
That's great. Wow. I know that I am excited, and a lot of players will be looking forward for this new project and the future of Rappel Z. Thank you very much, Torja.
You're welcome.
Well, hey guys, I hope you guys liked the news of this week. A lot of work was put into it. So if you guys could, don't forget to subscribe. Hit that notifications bell. Don't forget to leave me a like and a comment in the end of this video, because that helps a lot the channel, helps a lot of people be able to see Rappel Z content and even bring some people back to the game. So thank you very much for watching, and I hope you guys have a great week, and I'll see you in the game.